My name is Krishnan Chatterjee. I lead marketing for HCL Technologies, which is an IT services company in India, and also happens to be one of the 5 fastest growing technology companies in the world.
So we've been doing a lot of writing about the consolidation in the Indian IT industry. Now, how do you think HCL stands out in the clutter that's there?
So I think if I go back, you know, to answer that question, I'll have to go back about 5 years in time, back to 2005, which is when HCL started its journey of differentiation. And at that point of time, the way we saw the Indian industry is it was rapidly commoditizing, in the sense that there was a significant linearity that had got established between manpower and revenue. So anybody in the industry who said that last year I added $100 million of revenue would have in the same breath told you that I added 20,000 more people. And that linearity of the business model was creating, you know, the sources of competitive advantage were becoming administration, recruitment, bus route scheduling and things like that, which obviously did not lend themselves very well to significant differentiation in a technology-led business. What we did in HCL at that time was, we said that we have to break that linearity. Now, one obvious way to go away and become unique and differentiated in that linear business model is to say, let's go away and create products and make IP and let that drive the business. If you think a little bit more about that, that could not be the source of differentiation because it did not align to the source of advantage that India as a location has in our industry. Instead of that, what we went away and did is a philosophy called employees first, customers second, which actually is premised on the belief that the value in our business is created in the interface between our employees and our customers' employees, and a whole bunch of things that we do to ensure that our employees in the value zone maximize their ability to create value for customers. So rather than go somewhere else to solve the problem, create non-linearity by making each individual in the business capable of doing a lot more than they would have done in the past.
So we talked a little bit about how marketing is changing to the point where the marketer has less and less control over the touch points.
Yeah.
And one of the key causes for that is the rise of digital media. So
yeah.
How are you actually using that medium for HCL?
So I think what we need to understand, so let's take a look at why marketers are losing control over their touch points. They're fundamentally, so I'll go back to the way I defined a brand. A brand is a desirable promise made to consumers, which is unique within its consideration set. So when I look at that factor of desirable has a lot to do with socio-political and cultural environments. So if something is unacceptable in your supply chain, a Starbucks or a Nike gets into trouble. As consumers change, let's say you get far more of Generation Y today consuming. They behave fundamentally in very different ways. They change how your brand is perceived. When your competition makes significant moves, so today, for instance, a Nokia is repositioned on account of what an Apple did. With so many factors outside your control, the reason why you lose control over your brand is because the multiple touch points your brand interacts with or uses to engage have become democratized by virtue of digital media and social networking. Consequently, what is the most fundamental way we as marketers need to use digital media? I think we need to first recognize the fact that our brands will only be different as long as our business models are unique and our business models live up to the promise that our brands make. A brand cannot be a cosmetic thing anymore. The minute you have a unique business model which you define to be part of the brand, then you need to leverage social media through communities who will be able to, let's say, evangelize that model, who are excited by that model, and as various consumers or other influencers or other people you interact with in the market engage with your brand through digital media, they find that the promise your brand holds is a real and desirable one. So in my case, the way we work on digital media is we look at multiple communities, whether it be young engineering students in colleges, whether it be MBAs, whether it be our own employees who are a very, very significant component of evangelism, or whether it be our customers, and we build unique digital engagement properties for all these audiences.
So if the marketing god fairy gave you 3 wishes, what would you wish for?
The first thing I would wish for is a business model which can do 3 things. Item number 1, it makes my customer, the CIO, a rock star in his own business. Item number 2, it makes every single employee in the company believe that they have maximized their potential by virtue of being part of HCL Technologies. And item number 3, that as a consequence of 1 and 2, my organization achieves a share of mind in the market which significantly outstrips its share of market.
Great. And I also know that you have interests outside of marketing. So if people want to look up your band, where can they find it? And you also run a blog on marketing, where can they find that?
Yeah, so outside of work, or actually inside work, because half my band is from HCL, I have a band called Contraband. We do a lot of original music, primarily blues rock. So you can find us on www.contraband.in, which will take you to our Facebook page. Please do like us, that helps us a lot and encourages us, keeps us motivated to write lots of new music. And my blog is called Marketing Muse, and it's on Posterous.